Hi, we're Cerebral Bore.
And you're getting your fix of metal injections.
Hey guys, it's Noah here with Paul and Sam from a band called CEREBRAL. You guys are here in New York. It's one of your only stops on this tour. I just want to say thank you so much for coming here.
Thank you for having us.
Thanks. You guys recently signed with Earache, yep. Right?
Yes, we did.
So tell us about how that phone call went. How was the reaction? What did you guys feel like when that happened?
That was good. We sent a link to, there was a demo submission thing on the website. We submit your MySpace address. So we did that. And then we got an email back within the hour from Earache, and they said we were already preparing a contract proposal, so it was a coincidence.
Oh my goodness,
yeah,
wow.
So that was the only label we went to with the album after it was done, you know. That was the only label we submitted something to, you know. So yeah, it was pretty good.
That's amazing. So sending your demos really does work. You just have to do it in a professional manner, right?
Yeah, we sent the album, you know. It was album tracks we sent, so they were well produced and stuff. I think we sent the demo like 5 years ago, and we didn't get a reply. It was a piece of shit.
Well, something changed from 5 years ago, and I think probably Sam, you joined the band.
Okay.
Maybe that also helped.
Oh, there was tons of stuff that changed since then. Like, those songs were shit as well. Like, everything's like progressed since then, but yeah, Sam joined last year, like last April or some shit.
Yeah, it was last summer, almost exactly a year ago, so.
Yeah, I mean, you were kind of like this YouTube sensation.
I guess so, yeah.
So did you guys see her YouTube videos?
No.
And then no, not
no,
at all.
No,
so how did you audition for CEREBRAL?
Well, that's what everyone thinks, it's not true, but it's not true.
Yeah, it was actually like I did a live guest performance with a one-man band called Put Your Pile. That's when they heard first of me, because they were on tour with him. And then I posted a Facebook message simply saying, I'm still looking for a band, this and that. Even want to do merch, if that's right. And he said, well, you can do merch. And by the way, we're still looking for a vocalist, so you can come over and audition for us if you want. So that's where it happened, like when it started.
So was there any type of like reluctance to bring her on board? Were you like, oh my God, she's a girl. How is she gonna front this grind band?
We've been through quite a lot of members. Well, a lot of vocalists. It's the one department that we've had a lot of trouble with. We've never really found the right person. So like now, like when it came to that point when we lost another vocalist and we had to find a new one, by that point we're really apprehensive when it comes to like getting people in the band. I was more worried about her age than anything. It was like, she's pretty young. Is she going to be able to handle it? Like, are her parents going to support her? Or are they always going to be like on her back to like quit the band and like get a real job? But that was the only thing I was apprehensive about. Like the female thing, nah, that was fine.
Gave
her the same.
How old are you?
Now I'm 19.
What do your parents think of all this? I mean,
they're so proud. Yeah, they're really, really supportive. They support me with anything I do in the band. Like,
they come to shows wearing t-shirts.
Yeah.
They
came to one show in Rotterdam while we're on tour, and they just came into the door with CEREBRAL Bore shirts. So that was amazing. Then they just had thanks for fun, and they're really supportive. They're awesome.
That's really cool. So from what I find from the reactions to the Maniacal Miscreation, which is your album right now, that's out right now, is there are a lot of reactions from, you know, like the people that listen to it, and they're like, oh my God, I didn't even know that Sam was a girl.
Yeah. That's the biggest reaction we get quite a lot, actually. Like,
yeah, so do you get a lot of guys that come up to you in the shows and they're like, I had no idea?
Yeah, I do actually, yeah, but...
So you get a positive response otherwise, right?
Yeah, it's just they're pretty positive about it as well, but yeah.
What's the band dynamic like? Because back in October, I posted an article about CEREBRAL Bore. It was right when I...
Oh, was that the one on Invisible Oranges?
It was through Invisible Oranges, that's how I found out about it.
All right.
And then I posted it on Metal Injection.
That's right, I think you mentioned Invisible Oranges in
yes,
that.
Yes, I did.
Yeah,
yes,
I remember.
So
we were in Israel actually when we read that, don't you remember? We were getting the tattoos. And we were like, that's me reading the thing on Metal Injection, remember? I remember that. We were in that house in Israel.
Yeah, alright.
In fact, wait a minute, that's wrong. She wasn't there, it was her bass player, Kyle.
We were getting tattoos,
that's when I read that.
I do remember reading it myself, but...
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, because I posted it on Facebook that night when I saw it.
Well, I thought it was really cool because in the comments, some of the guys were like, oh, her vocals are layered, oh, it's not real, there's so many effects. And then Paul starts commenting, hey guys, I can reassure you that she can really pull it off live, it's true. So is there like that big brother dynamic? Do these guys take care of you or do you like abuse them?
No, they're like real family, yeah. So I know they will always have my back and I will always have their back. So yeah, it's like a bench should be, you know? So,
yeah. Well, how did you, I mean, you said that you always wanted to sing, so how did you find out that you could belch like that? I mean, because this area is for baby making, it's not for growling.
I guess it was just luck, I think. I just heard a band doing screams and growls at the same time. I was like, that can't be one person. I was so shocked it was one person doing that. So then I just, you know, did it for fun, just trying it and I just started out with simple screams, you know, like, and then I was really bad though. I really sucked because I didn't know how to do it. I just did it for fun. Yeah. And it was a sort of addiction for me. I could never leave it alone. I always had to be better, do that.
There's some stuff online of you when you were like 15 and stuff, isn't there?
There was a cover video when I was 13, but I took it off the internet. People were just like, what's this? She's so bad. She's so bad. It was me being so bad. But I was just 13, like that, you know? So, yeah, but practice
makes perfect, exactly.
Yeah, so that's basically it.
So, I'm sorry, Paul, I don't mean to, like, not include you in this conversation.
No, go for it.
But do you find that there are a lot of girls that are, like, showing solidarity at your shows? And they're there, you know, just to, like, support you? Yeah, all right, female fronted metal, let's go again.
I do get quite a lot that girls come up to me and, like, good you're standing up for us. Good that you're showing that we can do metal as well.
Right.
Yeah, but I don't really mean to be like that, but they just... show respect, like...
Right, I think it's just a natural reaction because you don't try to come off as something that you're not.
No, of course, no, yeah.
So what's next for Cerebral Board?
Well,
what are you guys doing?
We're on a tour right now, so this is our first...
Yeah, we fly to Dallas in the morning, and then we start the proper tour for the next couple of weeks. Then we go to Mexico on the 16th, 15th.
Okay, you know they say don't drink the water in Mexico.
Yeah, yeah. There's a couple of
places. Unless you want to add another stage element.
Yeah.
Some explosive diarrhea.
From every orifice. Yeah, so we've got that. We're doing the Mexico thing. We're going to be on a movie soundtrack coming up soon, but we can't say anything about it because we only heard this morning, but like it's going to be awesome. And they're using the song in the trailer. So it's going to be good. It's good. It's awesome. We only found this out this morning when we spoke to our label.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Just seemed like bigger and bigger things are happening to us. We're like, can't be any bigger than this. And then we heard this and that. And it's just...
Yeah, we go to India as well. We're playing a fest in India in September. We go to Ukraine in September as well. These are pretty obscure countries, you know. What else? I don't know.
Nah. I think we'll be all right. We're really excited about going to India and see all this stuff.
We're doing a show with Motorhead in August. We're supporting Motorhead and Wasp and like Immortal and all that on the same bill. That's funny.
Yeah.
That's like every metalhead's dream come true right there.
We'll see if we can get a drink with Lemmy. Get that drink on.
Or, you know, 10.
As many as Lemmy can handle. I'll be the last man standing.
Awesome. Well, I'm so happy that you guys took the time out to talk to all of us. And
I wish you
the best of luck.
Cheers.
So make sure you catch Cerebral Bore on tour, check them out online, buy The Maniacal Miscreation on Earache Records. Thank you.
Please do.
Thank you.
Cheers.